Saturday Night at the Movies is produced for in-house entertainment only. Due to copyright, the full movie cannot be shown on YouTube, only the original trailer.
Saturday Night at the Movies with Ben Bowditch.
Welcome to Saturday Night at the Movies, the season final for 2021. Great to be with you. Director John Sturges adapts filmmaker Akira Kurosawa's 1954 Japanese film Seven Samurai into a westernized version called The Magnificent Seven. A group of bandits led by Calvera regularly raid a poor Mexican village, stealing their food and supplies. After the latest raid, during which Calvera kills a villager, the village leaders decide they have had enough. On the advice of the village elder, they decide to fight back. The villagers hire Chris Adams, an experienced gunslinger. Chris forms a team of six other men in order to save the Mexican village. The professional gunmen train the villagers to defend themselves and stop the annual invasion of their town. Composer Elmer Bernstein's unforgettable theme music of blaring trumpets and thumping drums, together with an all-star cast, makes for one of the best unforgettable westerns of the 1960s. Starring Yul Brynner, Eli Wallach, Steve McQueen, Charles Bronson, Robert Vaughn, Brad Dexter, James Coburn, and Horst Buchholz. Saturday Night at the Movies remembers this western favourite, The Magnificent Seven.
Seven, 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 The Magnificent Seven. They were only seven, but they fought like 700 to bring the kind of justice that would last. Seven, 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 The Magnificent Seven. They fought for the future to wipe away their past. The Magnificent Seven.
Ride on.
Ride on. Somehow I don't think you solved my problem.
Solving your problems isn't in our line.
We deal in lead, friend.
So do I. We're in the same business, huh?
Only as competitors.
Get up and face me! Do you hear? Get up!
Look what I found.
So that's where they were. You hid them.
Sure they hid them, but she won't tell me where. They're afraid. She's afraid of me, you, him, all of us. Farmers. Their families told them we'd rape them.
Seven, seven, seven.
innocent seven. They were only seven, but they fought like 700 to bring the kind of justice that would last. They made a brave stand, the magnificent seven. They fought for the future to wipe away their past. Seven, 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 the magnificent seven. The magnificent seven.
Another great Western classic to wrap up the 2021 season. Here is a look back on the classic movies featured this year here at Saturday Night at the Movies.
I just stopped travel around here. I don't start it.
Well, what's wrong with my working here?
Well, it's undignified. It's unladylike. More than that, you ought to be home doing needlework, things like that.
Sewing buttons on for some man, I suppose.
Well, buttons come off. Someone's got to sew them on.
That's a fine career for an intelligent woman.
Here are your tax notices, Wade.
Oh, thanks.
There will be wailing and gnashing of teeth when these go out. Oh, Abby, I know this isn't in your line, but as long as you insisted on the job, will you stop calling them cows in the stockyard? They're steers. Steers.
Well, I don't see any difference. A rise is expected this season in the price of longhorn cows.
Never mind. I'll correct this copy myself.
Longhorn cows. Well, I must be running along. By the way, may I let you into a little secret?
What?
You've got a smudge of ink on your nose.
Bye. Goodbye, Joe. Goodbye. Sorry, with Abby.
Is this showing proper respect for the law?
I never saw the law fall on his face before.
It didn't fall on my face. You know, there's an old saying in the British Army. The law must always save its face in front of the natives.
And what if the natives object to its face?
We just put them across our knee and spank them soundly.
You're not suggesting that I'm a native?
No. The only real native of Kansas is the buffalo. He's got a very hard head, a very uncertain temper, and a very lonely future. Apart from that, there's hardly any comparison between you. Goodbye, Joe.
Goodbye, Wade.
Goodbye.
I like that fella.
I never knew it could be like this. Nobody ever kissed me the way you do.
Nobody?
No, nobody.
Not even one? Out of all the men you've been kissed by?
Now that it takes, I'm figuring. How many men do you think there have been?
I wouldn't know. Can't you give me a rough estimate?
Not without an adding machine. Do you have your adding machine with you?
I forgot to bring it.
Then I guess you won't find out, will you?
Maybe I already know.
What's the matter? What are you hinting at?
Why, is there something to hint at? Maybe there's been a long line of beach parties.
You must be crazy.
Am I?
Beg you! Beg!
Beg for what?
Beg! Beg like my mother and father begged!
Your mother? Yeah. Here. Here, maybe you want this, huh? Years for this, so get it over with. Come on. Oh, finish me. Finish me! Please! I haven't got the guts! You yelling! Finish me!
You're just not worth killing.
Jim found himself, was again on the true path, the bright path, teaching and helping young people everywhere. This was his greatest victory. And tonight, the state of Oklahoma adds another great name, another portrait to its hall of fame. Ladies and gentlemen, the man whose achievements and records will live forever in the annals of sport. Acclaimed by the American press as the greatest athlete in the past half century, Jim Thorpe, All-American. With all the others.
Would you have done this to me if the Falcon had been real and you'd got your money?
Don't be too sure I'm as crooked as I'm supposed to be. That sort of reputation might be good business, bringing high-priced jobs and making it easier to deal with the enemy. But a lot more money would have been one more item on your side of the scale.
If you'd loved me, you wouldn't have needed any more on that side.
Come in. Hello, Tom. Got him?
Got him.
Swell. Here's another one for you. She killed Miles. Oh, and I've got some exhibits. The boy's guns, one of Cairo's, and $1,000 bill I was supposed to be bribed with. And this black statuette here that all the fuss was about. What's the matter with your little playmate? He looks brokenhearted. I bet when he heard Gutman's story, he thought he had me.
Cut it out, Sam.
Well, should we be getting down to the hall?
Harry, what is it?
The stuff that dreams are made of.
Huh?
Thank you. kindly stay off the bridge and in your cabin?
Engine room reports pressure still dropping, sir.
All right. Rig up boat number two. Mr. Kirshner.
Schleider, don't let there be a next time.
I told you if you brought sheep on this range, I'd kill you.
Morgan.
Why did you keep coming? I warned you. Why didn't you stop?
Stop? You stopped me.
Well, why did you have to be so stubborn?
Me? Me, stubborn?
Yes, you. You saw that gun. I told you I was going to shoot you. You knew I'd shoot you. You wouldn't listen to me.
I'm going to have a lot of trouble with you, among other things. Enough.
He's calling.
He killed Harvey. You can't let him go. Maddox!
It's over, Jace.
I don't crawl.
He'll kill you.
Keep your hands off of me. I'm not afraid of him. Harvey'd have walked fire for you.
He's my son, Maddox.
Don't beg him!
Where are you going?
Can you tell me where the 328th be?
It's up that way someplace. Where'd you pick up all this bunch?
We'll back up the line a ways. You couldn't be taking them off our hands, could you?
What would we do with them?
Well, I don't rightly know. Can we be going?
Sure, go ahead.
Thank you. Come on.
Forward!
All right, smash.
Come along. Never.
Watching them, Joe. Beg your pardon, sir.
Yeah?
We all got some prisoners. Can we be leaving them here?
Mm-hmm. Put them right over there. Wait a minute. How many have you got?
Well, I done counted 132 heads, sir.
We haven't room for that many here. Take them back up the line.
Yes, sir, but...
But what?
Well, sir, we can't find our outfit, and we tried to drop them off to other places, and there ain't but only eight of us to handle them.
You should have brought more men.
But that's all the war of us, sir.
You mean to say that you and seven others captured all that bunch?
Yes, sir. And we'd kind of like to get rid of them.
Well, good Lord. I guess we can give you some help. Come on, Sergeant.
Thank you.
Bait, Admiral.
AF has to be midway out.
Our three carriers and their escorts are all that stands between the enemy fleet and the American coastline.
Wrong, Admiral. If you send our carriers into a Japanese ambush, the entire West Coast and the Hawaiian Islands will be wide open for invasion.
I've fallen in love with a Japanese girl.
6 months after Pearl Harbor, boy, you have one lousy sense of timing.
Damn it, I'm an American. What makes us different from German Americans or Italian Americans?
Pearl Harbor, I guess.
Our objective is Midway.
Admiral Yamaguchi advises that we launch an attack on the American carrier immediately.
that we send our bombers out however they're armed.
Well, gentlemen, it started. Signal Spruance.
Hold it right there. Now put up your hands. Turn around.
Jim McKay. What in the world are you doing here?
Just haunting an old house, ma'am.
You're too noisy for a ghost. Where's Pat? Surely you're not riding around here alone.
If you're going to tell me this is a big country, I'm going to be disappointed in you.
Doggone the dad, Bernie. Stuck in the creek.
All right, folks, unload and give us a push.
Ain't nothing else to do. Here's where we start playing horses.
Dreadful situation. I shall most certainly write the Bureau of Rivers and Harbors about this.
Oh, oh, get out of there.
Oh, oh, no. Don't put me here. Don't put me here.
There you are. Now then, you stay there. If you behave yourself, I may come back and get you.
As you can see at a glance, it's a lot of uncoordinated activity. No teamwork. Some of those parties are actually working against each other.
Yes. I tell you, gentlemen, we have a problem on our hands. Thanks to the Japanese, we now command a rabble. There's no order, no discipline. Our task is to rebuild the battalion.
Yes, sir.
It isn't going to be easy, but fortunately, we have the means at hand. The bridge.
The bridge, sir?
The bridge. We can teach these Indians a lesson in Western methods and efficiency that will put them to shame. We'll show them what the British soldier is capable of doing.
Yes, I see your point, sir.
I realize how difficult it's going to be in this godforsaken place where you can't find what you need. But there's the challenge.
I beg your pardon, sir. You mean you really want them to build a bridge?
You're not usually so slow in the uptake, Evans. I know our men. You've got to keep them occupied. Fact is, if there weren't any work for them to do, we'd invent some, eh, Reeves?
That we would, sir.
So we're lucky. But it's going to be a proper bridge. Now, here again, I know the men. It's essential that they should take a pride in their job. Right, gentlemen?
Yes, sir.
Reeves, you're the key man in this situation as engineer. Tell me what you want, and Hughes and I will organize it. What do you think? Can we make a go of it?
We'll do our best, sir.
Fine. We must draw up our plans, then arrange a conference with Saito, and set him straight.
It's all right, son. At least we're not in it. We'll build it up again.
Couldn't they have done it anyway?
Against a rifle?
Couldn't they?
Not so easy. All right, hang on.
And I'd figure I was owed about all the gold we could carry out of these mountains.
Looks like you've got a pretty good claim.
Oh, it's a gold mine, honey. Why don't you come on over and take it?
Always fancied yourself faster than me. Draw, you damn tin horse! When I questioned you about that boy, I should have gone a bit deeper into the subject of character.
I came to Coarse Gold to be married. And that's what I'm going to be. Married.
She's been going down the mountain to see.
I'll say one thing, she's sure worth the trip.
Looks like a warm one.
Stars fade and fall, and I won't care at all, as long as I have you. Every kiss brings a thrill, and I know that it will, as long as I have you. Let's think of the future, forget the past. You're not my first love, but you're my last. Take the love that I bring, then I'll have everything, as long as I have you. Let's think of the future, forget the past. You're not my first love, but you're my last. Take the love that I bring, then I'll have everything, as long as I have you. As long as I have you.
As long as I.
People calls this hell, but you're still in Oklahoma territory. Save your breath. I don't know who hung you or why, but if you're innocent, the judge will set you free. And if you ain't, we'll have to take trouble hanging you again. So come on, get on your feet.
Get any tired of it? A bit, sir. Not if she keeps still just for a minute or so.
Well, at least we're dry. We'd know all about it if we had to turn round and steam into it.
Yes, sir. Message from my sir. Roundup number 86, who still appears to be strangling astern of the convoy.
Very good. I spoke too soon. Pass the word. We're going to turn beam on.
Like the end of our freight line, doesn't it, Charlie? Here you are.
How about you, Mr. Lockhart? You heading back to Fort Laramie?
Fort Laramie?
Ain't that where you come from?
I come from Laramie. I didn't say anything about a fort.
I figured you were an army man.
Now I'm heading back to town.
I like working for you, Mr. Lockhart. I sort of hate to leave you.
Well, maybe this won't be the kind of work you like.
If it's got anything to do with who's selling repeating rifles to the Apaches, I'd like to help.
I've got a personal stake in finding this man, Charlie. What's yours?
They've always been a nosy man. While you're going into town, maybe I'll head up north and poke my big nose around.
Up north? That's Apache land up there.
In my case, that's not so dangerous. My mother was one.
Giveaway.
Right and left, pace. And a trail forward. Head.
Another great year of movie memories. Thanks for watching, and until next time, it's goodbye for now. This presentation has been produced by Ditchbow Media Productions. Don't forget to press the subscribe button and also the bell to receive notifications of new videos.